Hey, what's up, everyone? Devron here, back again with another Let's Paint. And I'm gonna do another cell painting, but with a few differences. One, my canvas is bigger. And two, I'm gonna be making cells out of pixels made with basic pencil strokes and shape tools. So basically, like what I did with the spray can pixels in my last Let's Paint, but I want to show you guys the cells being made with again, regular pencil strokes and shape tools. And I'm gonna go get started. So I'm gonna take this blue gray and I'm just gonna scribble, just regular scribbling. I'm gonna have some fun. So here we go. So just basic, easy, free mouse movement, and I'm just scribbling and scribbling and scribbling, and it's fun. And if I zoom out, it'll kind of look like that, but then I'll have that rendering thing. So if I want to zoom out, I can really start to see where, whoops. That's okay. Yeah, when I right click, it will disappear like that. Okay. So now we're gonna just wanna cover up the whole canvas. Just have fun covering up this canvas here. Whoops. Yeah, it's gonna render like that because I got it zoomed out. So when I put it to like 100, it'll be back to normal. So here we go. Then I zoom in, it's just gonna be on. Basically the full regular size, but I'd have to scroll to like fill it up whatever portion. So I'm just basically just free mousing it. Having fun covering up the canvas with scribbles. Go. Where else didn't I hit? Oh, not enough of this portion. think that's enough of the pencil stroke scribbling. So now I'm going to take another, I'm going to take this light turquoise. And now I'm going to take this single stroke, single pixel stroke, and I'm going to put in some, actually, I'm going to use the darker one. Okay, there we go. Better yet. And I'm just going to just have fun putting in some shapes. Basically, it's like how I'd make something. Perhaps like back in the good old days. But this is how I'm making my cells. Yep, put in some stars, why not? By the way, yeah, I'm using this indigo and this blue gray. I'm just gonna use like, it's gonna be a three color. I don't wanna go crazy on color. So that's why I'm using just these two. And yeah, and I'll even use lines. And just use more circles. Here. Like ovals or circles or whatever. Just going ahead and just going free mouse. Okay. Doesn't matter where I want to position them. So yeah, again, I'm not going crazy on color. I'm just using these two. I'm not making it like a Roy G. Biv or a CMYK or like the vaporwave colors or just these two. Okay, now I think I made it really messy enough. Okay, a little more. All right. Very messy. Pencil strokes and shape tools. All right. So now that we did all the fun stuff, now we're going to move on to the serious side of things. So what I want to do is I'm going to select all. and then enlarge it that way. Resize, I'm making sure that's checked. And then, there we go. Put it right there. And basically, when I have it at 100%, nothing really weird. So then I'm gonna select all again. Because if I resize this without selecting all, it's gonna resize the whole canvas. I just want a basic zoom in. Do it one more time. All right. Let's see where I want. I'll have it basically right about here. We'll see. Let's see. Okay, that's gonna be fine. What's a good? How about right here? Or or yeah, we can do about right about here could be good. Okay, because I'm using, something like that. Because again, I'm using scribbles and shape tool to so about here. Yeah. So that will just about do. Right. So the next step, it's basically going to be everything else from the last Let's Paint. It's the about the same routine, but I can make one difference. If I need to position something, if I need to do repositioning, I can do that later. But right now we got our random colors. So now I'm gonna go ahead and start dividing these. So I'm gonna take this, get bold, and I'll start anywhere, any spot the pixels divide. And it looks like some of them might not really do so, but well. Do what we can. So I'm gonna start over here. This. Just want to make sure it's really even. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Good. Yeah, actually, let's use. Gonna use it that way. There we go. Then I'm gonna go ahead and start dividing them up into cells. Here we go. Scroll down since it's vertical. I'll copy. And I'll go ahead and paste. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, yep. So, since I made it a bigger picture, there's going to be more than what I had. So, more to divide. of course. Right here. That's easy enough. Here we'll divide from like right there. Whoops. That's what happens when you scroll like that. But that's okay. So it looks like in this spot, looks like we don't have any different colors, so that's what I'm gonna do about that. Take these, going to do that, same color. And I'll do it like that. And easy enough, but not gonna go too crazy. So now I'm gonna go ahead and put in all these dividers, all the vertical ones at least. And I'll go from there. Okay, so now I got all the vertical dividers in. Now it's time to work on the horizontal. Okay, so I'm gonna take what I just, the divider I copied, I'm gonna rotate it 90 degrees and control X. There we go. And then I'm going to had to make it. There we go. And I could do it like we're good. Make sure it lines up. And there we have it. Then I can go like about here. There we go. It fuses, then I'll And make it a little darker since it's blending in with the blue-gray. Then I'll go ahead and put these in. Whoops. Okay, maybe it was a little too soon. But either which way, I'm not really that. It's not really a project I really want to rush anyway. I'll go ahead and work on the rest. Okay, so now we got all the pixels divided up, or should I say the cells divided up. So now, just gotta make sure we gotta get it all looking good. So now, correct that mistake. One little missing portion there. There we go. Now we got them divided up. So now for the next step. Now we're ready to carve a cell out. So what am I gonna pick for starters? I'm gonna pick this blue-gray one. So what do we got here? 142. Just gonna set it to 140. And then I'm gonna give 120. Let's start with that. Then I'm gonna put in some walls. Whoops. With this. Alright, so I'll make it just about here. Or actually, something like that. We'll take this. I'll give it about 160. This will be for the floor. We'll have about this size. Just guesstimate. Oops. X. Alright, so I'm going to take this. Little bit. More. So what I'll do with that is I'll cut out the excess light blue that way. Cut out excess, so that should be about good right there. Copy, paste. Actually, yeah, I like it a little up a little more. There we go. I just want to make sure I get a measurement I want. I'm going to put horizontal and there we go. Got the wall. So next I'm going to put another wall, but put about here. And we'll have it the other way around. Stretch it up. Then I'll take what I got. Right click. Flip horizontal when I rotate. There we go. Take that. There we have it. Because in the last Let's Paint, the walls went like this, so I'm doing it this way this time. Okay. I'm gonna set about 100 for now. I'm gonna put in a put in the hole. So what do I got about? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Fit in a little more. That up. Selections. Yeah, that's the only thing that changed. Alright, so. Take this. Just gonna darken it up a little. Use about this size. Okay. All right, there we go. It's a little darker. Actually, I'm gonna take that. None. Copy in. And paste. Yep, sure, that's the only thing that changed. Gonna make this red for now. Now I'm gonna actually just gonna pick a color. Just make sure. Make sure it winds up right. That's okay. And then I'll get rid of these guides. There we have it. We got the hole put in. Now let's put the holes in the walls. In the side walls. Alright. I'm gonna use that. Actually, I'm just gonna give it a 10. And then I'll insert one right here. Make it a little wider. Gotta zoom in first. Okay. Yep. Just about right. All right, let's. Let's make a little. Wider, larger. Okay, so there, yeah, that should just about do. Forty for now. Okay, let's make that a little shorter. How's that? Yeah. I don't know, I guess I'll do. Okay. Well, actually, that's not really necessary. We'll just take that. Whoop. Wasn't really looking to cut. I was looking to copy, but same. Work the same way. There we go. There we have it. We got a cell carved out. So now what I'm gonna do, okay, yep, got that. Or actually, forgot one thing. Gonna give that Gonna give some detail to the dividers. Gonna keep this portion as is. Actually, 125. I know I'm kind of getting a little carried away. Want to do this step first. Whoops. I just want to make sure I get what I want, at least as far as the result. Change colors later. And there we go. And also, so I won't be doing the whole dividers for detail, I got that. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this. I'm gonna copy and I'm gonna paste the carved out portion on all. I wanna make sure it's right. And I'm gonna paste these all over all the squares painted with the blue gray. I'm gonna go ahead and paste them all here with this color. Okay, so now I got the blue-gray cells carved in, but as I was doing that, I noticed one little mistake I made. I know I get a little carried away with my last video, but we need to insert the walls and the holes over here. So what we're going to do before we go ahead with the next color, I'm going to go ahead and insert walls in there, just so we can make it a little more. Because I made a bigger hole this time. And then I'll get rid of the guides. Oops. And then I'll go ahead and do that. Sure, I line them up. I mean, no, I'm not perfect in my progression in this, but I want to check things to make sure I get what I want. So I'll go ahead and get this taken care of. Because, you know, sometimes I gotta really keep an eye on things. Okay, so now that little issue is fixed, now we can move on to the next color. And I'm thinking about the dark blue. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over here. Gonna take this. It's 126, so I'll trickle it down to 120. So I'm gonna use this as the substitute. And I'll take 100 or how about 95? Yeah, 95 is a little bit. I'll What color did I make this again? Oh yeah, 160. So, see what I do with 140. Give it 100. Okay. So there we go. So I'll copy this, and then I'm gonna undo the coloring of this one. Just pressing Control Z. And it's out of, maximize its undoing, so well. There we go. So now what I'm going to do now I will do the same thing with the with all these indigo or dark blue, whatever. I'll go ahead and paste. Now, and I fix this up a little with the wall being seen in the holes. I don't have to go back and do that. So, now I'll go ahead and work on all these blue color or indigo, whatever you want to call them all. Work on those cells. Whoop. And by the way, if get cell up here, I'll make sure it lines up. Looking good. Okay, so now keep going in. I'll start pasting these over the rest. Okay, so now we got the blue cells all carved out. So now, last but not least, we got the white colored cells here. So we're gonna I'm going to go ahead and bit about I'm gonna go ahead and get these. That's still too bright. There we go. Okay. So now that I got this brightly. Now I'll go ahead and fix that. There we go. And now, I will work on all these white ones. So it's not too bright. We had a I really had to adjust that. And yeah, I've been like copying like a group of these like this. And then grouping them that way. For like another group of four. Paste them here. And in a group of three, we can eyeballing this. Okay, good. Now, I'll go ahead and get these carved out. I could do something like that if need be. Okay. So now we got all the cells carved out. Whew. Yeah, so many of them too. But before I start coloring in the holes from this temporary red color, I'm gonna reposition a little. So right here we got like 1 pixel of So I'm gonna select all, and then whoops, let's make that white, the background color. Okay, select all. There we go, and let's cover up the red part down there. And all right. So what happens when I, now I can do that now. So what happens? All right, it looks better. Positioning's a little better too. Well, to adjust the, what do I mean by two? But anyway, yeah, sometimes did that. So anyway, so now that I got it positioned out, we'll go ahead and paste all these to get rid of this. To get rid of the white lines here. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Copy each of the corresponding colors and repasting them. All right, here we go. Okay, not quite done, but I just thought of a better idea. So move it up a little more. Okay, so how will the cells look at the bottom? A little more. Okay, much better. So much better. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to go ahead and get these cells fixed up. Okay, it's looking a little better. So now I got the repositioning all set. You know, the repositioning is really important to me because, you know, yeah, I know I positioned it a certain way after enlarging the pixels, but, you know, I don't want, like, ugly pixel slits at the edges, so and it's really unpredictable when I, like, draw my cell and then paste them on the edged portions. So that's why it's really important to me to do this little repositioning procedure. Because there's a lot more to this than just making a cell and then copying them on all these other places. It's more than that. You know, that's all. You know. But anyway, and also, you know, I want the flow too. That's really all I'm looking for. So anyway, now we're down to our final step. Now the final step, I'm going to be coloring the holes in to the right colors. So I'm replacing this red. So I can see the cell below it is like the indigo color. So I'm gonna take the eyedropper tool. And this one's the indigo color too. And then fill them in like so. Whoops. There we go. So there we go. So there's that blue-gray. This one's that blue-gray as well. And then whoops, Control Z. There we go, and we'll do it like that. This one, same thing. We got the light gray colored one. Then we'll do the same thing here. Got a blue. Some more grays. Got another gray. Do this in double time. Got another blue. And a gray. There we go, and we got our first row done, colored in. Yeah, I could do it in columns too. So there we go. So just make sure. Now I can start the next row and I'll keep going from there. All right. Okay, so I got those, but wait, what were those bottom colors again? So it looks like I'm going to need to do one more repositioning. Looks like we'll have to see how that works. Oh, a little better. So I guess I'll go ahead and take care of that. Oh, and whoops. Gotta keep an eye on this. Okay. Yep, right. Yeah, actually. Better idea. Or yeah, that's not gonna work. So if I had to do something like that, then we'll have to be aware of that. There we go. So let's take the one with the gray below it. There we go. So I'm going to keep going here. I'll get that fixed. Okay. There we go, but I think I'm not quite satisfied. Let's Let's see what happens in this position. What's it gonna look like? Select all again. So now what? It's gonna happen. Looks good, actually. So I'm gonna go ahead and do one more of this. Make sure they're blue. Yep. Here we go. There's one there. Okay. Now we got... Now I'm satisfied with the positioning. So now... There's one more thing. I think we can, let's see if we can position, brighten this up a little bit. Maybe darken it, yeah. So the colors aren't blending in too much. So yeah, I got those one. Yep, there we go. So yeah. I'm gonna go ahead and darken up the floor parts for the blue-gray ones. Here. Alright, so now we got that color taken care of. So just gonna do one quick look here. Okay. Good. 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 Of course we... kept a careful watch. Took it slow and... It took it slow when I was coloring the holes. Still. Okay. And good, we are finished. So that's the cell painting in another version with pencil scribbles and shape tools, rather than the spray can pixel. So yeah, It's kind of the same thing like last one, but, you know, a few differences. Scribbles, shape tools, and a larger size, and different wall position. So, a difference, it's like my fourth version of this kind of painting, but it's definitely got its, got three differences here. And, yeah. So, yeah, you know, kind of want to have, get the positioning how I want it and all that, but this is a pretty fun painting. I know. I mean, I don't know if I want to do another let's paint of a painting like this, but if I have any ideas, I'm sure I can do it. But anyway, again, I know I did one with five colors, but I like three colors used the best. But that's just me. But anyway, thank you so much, guys, for watching, and I hope you really enjoyed this. I know it's a lot of tedious work and all that, but whew, wow, my hand is hurting with using that mouse a lot, but either which way, I got the result here. So thank you guys for watching. Well, I will save this absolutely.